Hello friends, now we are going to study short transmission line. Before studying short transmission line, we have to take few assumptions in short transmission line, and the assumptions are following. The first assumption is the LF value should be less than or equal to 4000, means for F is equal to 50 Hertz, this L should be less than or equal to 80 kilometer. This is the first assumption. Now the second assumption is the effect of capacitance will be neglected. The effect of capacitance will be neglected because charging current is very small. So guys, see very carefully how we are just neglecting this. Let us assume we have one transmission line here, and this is the C capacitor. So for short transmission line, C will be basically in microfarad per kilometer in actual transmission line. So this will be very small in per kilometer. So if you talk about the C in microfarad, so C value will be equal to C into L. Microfarad, basically when we multiply by L, this will become C in microfarad. So if this L will be less, then this C will be less, because we know that the length of the short transmission line is small, so that this C will be very less. So the XC value, whatever we will write here, that will be 1 upon omega C. If once C is small, this XC will be very greater. So if we will find out the value of I, that will be equal to V upon XC. So if XC value is much greater, so the I value will be very lesser. So if short transmission line means the value of C will be very less, this XC value will be equal to very high, because XC will be equal to, we know that 1 upon omega C I have written here. So if X omega C is very small, so XC will be very large, so that if I will be calculating the value of current, that would be very less. So here this current would be very less. In comparison to what, basically? In comparison to load. Let us assume the load current is 200 ampere and this I is equal to 2 ampere. So 2 ampere is nothing in comparison with this 200 ampere. So we can neglect here the value of 2A. So that is why the effect of capacitance has been neglected, because charging current is very small. One thing I want to discuss with you, that the shunt parameter, this current that is going in capacitor is charging current, and the current that is going in resistor, shunt resistor, that is called as leakage current, IG. So IC and IG, basically two terms. So the second point is the effect of capacitance will be neglected because charging current is very small. The third point is the effect of conductance is also neglected. So this is also neglected because same leakage current is very small. So we can neglect the value of G. So now we have three assumptions. The fourth assumption is the remaining element will be R and L. RL parameter will be represented as lumped parameter. And you know the what is lumped parameter and distributed parameter. So this is lumped parameter. So now we are going to analyze the short transmission line. These are the basic assumptions. So we have remaining, that is, this will be R and this will be L. So R plus J into XL, this will be remaining transmission line. So let us assume we have one load connected at receiving end, one load connected at receiving end, that is lagging load. We can take any load. Right now I am taking for the ease, that is RL load. So this is, let us assume RL load, and this voltage is, this is basically voltage of receiving end VR, and this current is IR. Same way, this will be the voltage of sending end VS, and the current is sending end current is IS. So now we can see from here, we can also write this diagram as, we can also write this diagram at Z. Simply we can replace Z, and this will be VS, this will be IS, and now moving to receiving end, this is load, RL load basically. So this is RL load, this is RL load, and this is VR, and this is IR. So what we can write here from that, very important thing is VS value. If you want to write, then VS value we can write, see guys, VR plus IS into ZR or IR into Z. So we can write VR plus IR into Z. This is the first point. And IS value we can write, that is IS value is equal to IR, means IS is equal to, we have two given equation, this is equation number one and this is equation number two. From this we can calculate ABCD parameter. As I have told you, this is VS and this is IS, and this will be 1 Z 0 1. So this will be the parametrix for short transmission line, and this is VR and this is IR. So we have this ABCD parameter. If you are writing this, then this is A parameter, this is B parameter, this is C parameter, and this is D parameter. So now ABCD parameter we have found, and now we are going to draw the equivalent circuit diagram. We are going to draw equivalent circuit diagram. So while drawing equivalent circuit diagram, we have to remember the following point. First of all, the load is lagging in nature. So what we will do, we will write this equation number one, VS is equal to VR plus IR into Z. Z means R plus J into XL. So if I want to elaborate it, how I can elaborate is, that is VS is equal to VR plus R into IR plus J into R into IR plus J into IR into XL. So VS is equal to this. So now we have to draw this, and we also have the information, that is 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 equal to IR. So IS is equal to IR. So now we are going to draw the phasor diagram. So how we will draw? Let us assume VR is taken as reference, and we know that the IR is lagging VR by an angle of phi R, because our load is lagging in nature. So this is the load we have drawn. Now to calculate the value of VS, we have to add R into IR plus J into IR XL in VR. So first we will add R into IR. If IR is in same direction, so if you want to write R into IR, so R into IR we can write like this. So VR plus IR into IR plus we want to add, that is J into IR XL. J movement is, we know that is in anti-clockwise direction. So from here, anti-clockwise direction would be like this. So this will be IR into XL. And we also know that the value of XL is much, much greater than R. So the amplitude of IR XL will be greater than amplitude of R into IR. So from here, we can calculate, that is this is value VS, and this is IR is equal to IS. So the angle between VR and IR will be called as phi R, and the angle between VS and IS will be also called as phi S. So this is the sending in power factor angle. So we have drawn this, and now we are going to draw this for leading power factor. This is the circuit diagram for lagging power factor, and now I am going to draw the individual circuit for leading load, as well as I am going to draw the failure diagram for the leading load. So we have this time RC load. Leading load means RC load. So this is RC load, this is RC load. There would be confusion of students, so that this is VR and IR. Now we want to write the value of VS. So the value of VS, if you want to write that, then VR is the voltage across this RC load. So we do not need to write like in between the inductance R minus jXC, whatever it is. So we do not need to write that. Only we have to write like that the voltage across that, that is VR. So again, VS will be equal to VR plus IR into R plus J into XL. So this VS is equal to VR plus this drop. So there is no need to mention this RC load. So this is the simple, but this effect will be seen when we will draw the phasor diagram. So this is the VS is equal to VR plus IR into R plus J into XL. So taking voltage VR as reference. So taking voltage VR as reference, since the load is leading in nature, so IR is leading like this. So IR is leading like this. So if we want to write the value of VS is equal to VR plus R into IR. So first we will add R into IR. So first we will add R into IR. So this is R into IR. So VR plus R into IR. And now I will add into this, that is, I will add into this, that is J into XL. So IR into XL magnitude of, we will add into this. So from here, if you will calculate, it could be very long. So this is IR into XL. This is IR into XL. If you want to calculate this, then this will be our VS. So you can see clearly that this is the value of VS. If this is the angle between what? Phi R means receiving in current and receiving in voltage, and this is IR is equal to IS. So if now we want to calculate the value of sending in power factor angle in case of leading power factor, so that would be this angle, basically only this angle. You can see only this. So this will be equal to sending in power factor phi S. So this is the phasor diagram for short transmission line. Now we are going to calculate the voltage regulation formula, as well as the transmission line values, for what values the voltage regulation will be maximum or minimum. So this is all about the short transmission line. Thank you.